Yes, hello everybody. I know this is getting somehow out of control. Another machine I support now, and I promise this will be the last until there will be a new one. So I also got cheap machine in studio off from some secondhand selling service, and it really goes nicely with my Quark M3, which is also in the same white. And yeah, I could not resist to get it. And feature-wise, it's somewhere between the Mark II and the current Mark III. It seems to have much more options, but let's look into detail that it's actually not that much additional. So the feature set is pretty identical to what you can have with the Mark II or the Mark III, so I will not show every detail. That's why also I decided to start with a little jam intro into that. On the left you have here your normal transport control, which pretty does what it says. You can access the groups or the tracks here to select. What is the difference here? The shift key sadly is not working. This works only on the jam and on the Mark III, also not on the Mark II, so also not here. But luckily we have lots of buttons here on this model, so I sacrificed the back button here as a shift button, which I think is quite nice for usage. So yeah, that's a shift. And this model has dedicated buttons here for features which are normally on the other models, are also on the pads when you press shift. I left them here as well, so these features are still also on here on the Mark III, but you need to navigate them a little bit blind. But I thought, why remove them? Maybe for some people it might be come in handy. But nevertheless, there are here as well. So you have your undo and specific redo features, quantize and clear, and these things over here. Also, you see there is normally on the other models here this big control or small control knob, where you can also on a new model go in four direction. That's not here. Instead, we have that knob over here. So here you can change here the currently selected item, for example, here the track volume, and there are different modes. There are the specific mode knobs are missing on this model. So to change the mode here, you can use the enter key. So this is now the volume mode, and you can switch here with that into here the position mode. So you can change here the position of your play cursor, and if you go once more, you can change here the tempo, even either with that knob or also with the big knob here. Sadly, I cannot give you the indication what's currently active because the medium mode is a bit weird in some aspects. If I enable that, I get not a state anymore of the buttons, so I cannot use the buttons to move them as a cursor keys. So I decided better to keep the cursor keys working than to sacrifice here the indication. But I think it's not so bad because I put here some arrows so you see what's currently active and editable. Yeah, that's how it works. So that's basically already here this section over here. We have here the normal usability. The other difference here to the Mark III model is that we don't have here those four buttons on top. So we have here the pad mode to switch to this more drum layout, and if you go here with shift and the keyboard, you get this other play layout you also saw in the beginning. What is also a little bit different, that some buttons are over here, so we have a tap button up here, but the metro is down there. So that's also an advantage of this model, because on the other models it's only one button for tap and metro, so here you can have them individually. To switch that into sequencer mode, you can use here the step mode, which is normally on a Mark III over here, so it works the same way as well. And on the macro I put to create a new clip, so let's do that. We have a new clip on here, and let's also have a look at the sequencer mode. So the sequencer mode, you see, it's, if you say we have that one, it walks around here in the sequencer mode. Let's turn off here, so this is overdub. You can disable the overdub for the arranger, and with shift for the clip. And yeah, now here we can add notes for that selected note, can go back, select another note, One other specific is that area over here. So we have monitoring section, and this is also in the MIDI mode. Totally weird implementation, because if you change here the knob, it will always indicate it here on the LED as well. Relative mode is not usable by, but I implemented some kind of fake relative mode. The other thing is I cannot show the view meters here and use the knob at the same time, because if I get view values, it will override the current position of the knob, and then you have a weird volume, for example. So what I did is you can switch between view metering and using the knob. So yeah, okay, you have to live with that, but I think it's quite okay. If that in three, that's a button to toggle between these two modes, view metering and controlling different monitor aspects. So if that is enabled, you can use the knob. Let's check that out. This is currently here the master volume. So you can change the master volume. You can change here the volume of the currently selected track as well. That one changes the metronome volume. So let's turn on the metronome. So you can adjust it to your liking. Same is for the cue, so the headphone monitoring volume. It's also here, and the button on the left here, acceptor 1-3, this is then the panorama for the master track. This is the panorama for your selected track, and that one is the cue mix, so it's on the same area. And as I said, that one toggles between usage of the knob and the view meter, so let's check out that. So if I turn off in 3, you will get the view metering of the master track, and you can also switch to the currently selected track. That's another drawback of the MIDI mode. It's a stereo LED. You can only address them at once, so you can only see a mono value in that. Also, sorry for that, but that's how it works in the MIDI mode. Okay, so I think these are the specifics of this model. You should also watch my videos about the Mark II and the Mark III, and then I think you will get an understanding of all the things. Maybe let's have a quick look at installation, which is quite simple. So besides installing Driven by MOS extension, as usual, you need to install a template. So for that, you use the Native Instruments Controller Editor, switch to the Machine Studio View, which normally gets automatically selected if your device is connected. And what you then need to do is open and select here the Driven by MOS NCMST, and if you unzip the download, you will find all these Machina templates in the resources folder in there, and there you just need to go to the Machina Studio and open that. And what is very important is that you select the template in that editor and not on the device, because if you do it on the device, it will get stuck in a weird mode, which is always the case if you have MCU mode enabled, which is necessary that I can address the display. So this is not a drawback of my implementation. This is a drawback also on the device. If you get stuck in that mode here on the device, check out the manual, which is included in the download of the Driven by MOS manual. It will explain in detail how you can fix that and get out to that mode and get it going again. Okay, so much for a quick introduction, and I hope you like it and dig it and make some funky music.